This is a clip from the Street Dance Society that I go to every single week. And I know what you're thinking, Felix, you're a medic. How do you have the time to do all of this? Where's your work-life balance? Well, before I show you what happens next in this dance session, I don't really have work-life balance. I have something called work-life harmony. Let me explain. Hey guys, and welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Felix. I'm a second year graduate medic. And today I wanted to talk about work-life harmony, not work-life balance. Work-life harmony. See, when you start medical school, you're going to hear this term work-life balance thrown around a lot. The further along I get into medical school, the more I realize that this is not really realistic. Life is less like this perfect pie chart where there's exact divisions of time for everything that you do. It's more like a flywheel that's completely dynamic, where as your priorities change across the year, across your time during the medical course, the time that you put into each little segment of your life also changes. With that in mind, let me show you exactly how I view like my second year of medicine. So with second year, let's say I've got the start of second year and I've got the end of second year. End of second year is when we have exams. Now, in between, I essentially have three blocks, okay? Three separate blocks. In the first part, which is sort of freshers, a couple of months after we've started, so right around this region, I'm going to be spending more time on things around my life and less time on things around my work. Then as we move on to the second block, I'm going to be sort of equalizing where the amount of time I spend on life is going to equalize with the time I spend on work. And then towards the end, work is going to take over life, and nearing exams, work is completely going to be the main focus of my time. In between these things, where I've put like these little sticks, I have checkpoints, and these checkpoints are places where I've left a good bulk of time free, where I can sort of go to myself and say, hey, have I done X amount of work by this point? Because if I haven't, I need to spend as long as I need to in order to catch up, because if I don't catch up now, it's going to be extremely difficult for me to catch up later on because more work is coming my way. One essential thing to add about this is something called the MRT, which is the minimum required threshold. What this means is that throughout your whole year, there are certain parts of your life that you must take care of so that you can enjoy your work. And there are certain parts of your work that you must take care of so that you can enjoy your life. Now, what you'll see is that with this whole idea of work-life harmony, if you take a slice of my life throughout the year at any point, you'll actually see that there's no work-life balance here. It's completely and utterly imbalanced. I'm either doing more about life or I'm doing a lot more about work. And it's not imbalanced, at least in the traditional sense. Obviously, if you zoom out and look at it like a year, if you look on a long-term basis, things all add up. Just because you're imbalanced, don't just completely stop doing one thing in sake of the other. What you need is harmony, and harmony comes from knowing that you've done enough of your work to enjoy your life and enough of your life to enjoy your work. And the amount that you do in each segment changes as your priorities change. So the next time that you are at the beginning of the year and you want to go to that society event, go and do it. Or you want to go help a friend move in, go and do that too. Or in my case, if you want to get a group of friends together that are relatively sleep deprived to make a freestyle dance routine at the end of dance class so that the YouTuber can put it on their channel, go and do that too, because if I didn't do it, you wouldn't be able to see this. Enjoy.
You'll see what happens in Ghana, which basically stands for South Asian Street Dance, but there's like a variety of like different music. What's the best thing about Ghana?
Moving, calorie burning. I don't know. That was such a.
What's the best thing about Ghana, man?
The best thing about Ghana is how difficult it is, so I can't do it for us.
What's the best thing about Ghana?
But the vibes.
The vibes. Nice.
I do the same thing. I told you that I never would. I told you I changed, even when I knew I never could. Know that I can't find nobody else as good as you. I need you to stay. Need you to stay. I get drunk, wake up, I'm wasted still. I realize the time that I wasted. I feel like you can't feel the way I feel. I'll be f***ed up if you can't be right here.
You're singing it slow. You are.
Because of that, we don't have to.